Bee here, and welcome back to Environmental Science. I want you to picture a polar bear. We know that a polar bear lives in the Arctic, but why doesn't a polar bear live in a tropical rainforest or the Sahara Desert? Well, they can't live in those areas because their bodies are adapted for cold climates. They have a thick layer of fat under their skin to stay warm and would therefore overheat if they were in tropical or warm environments. Where an organism lives, in this case the polar bear in the Arctic, is its habitat. In today's lesson, we will be defining an organism's habitat and comparing it to an organism's niche, which is its role in that environment. But before we get started, let's look at our goals for this lesson. By the end, you'll be able to define habitat and niche. Compare an organism's habitat and its niche. An organism's habitat is the physical location where an animal lives. Let's look at the red fox. The red fox lives all over the world in areas such as the edges of forests and grasslands. However, this is just one small part of the red fox's habitat. An organism's habitat also includes shelter, food, and water. Shelter is the space an animal uses for protection from weather and predators. It is also a space for them to eat, sleep, and raise offspring. The red fox makes its shelter in a den. The fox den can be underground, in a cave, among rocks, or even in a hollow tree. When looking for a suitable habitat, the red fox will be sure to look for ample food and access to water. They will often drink water directly from a freshwater source, like a river or stream, and for food, they eat mice, voles, and hares. Together, the geographical location of the forest edge and grasslands, along with their dens, streams for water, and food to eat, make up the red fox's habitat. But how does this compare to its niche? If an organism's habitat is the physical location where it lives, its niche is how the organism interacts with its environment. This includes its role in the environment, how it contributes to its ecosystem, and all of its activities in the environment. The niche of the red fox is very specific. In fact, by definition, a niche can only support one organism, compared to a habitat that can support multiple organisms at once. In its habitat, the red fox's niche includes being a predator. As we previously mentioned, the red fox eats small mammals and other animals. Another part of the red fox's niche is its nocturnal nature, meaning it is most active at night. Foxes can be bitten by mosquitoes and other blood-sucking insects that are often most active at night, therefore becoming a host for numerous diseases. While these diseases are unfortunate as it pertains to the health of an individual red fox, diseases are a vital part of the ecosystem as a whole. Sometimes diseases in ecosystems can help keep population growth in check. However, sometimes a disease can become too widespread and cause damage to the balance of the ecosystem in the opposite way, wiping out too many populations and communities. Another role of the red fox in its niche is to supply food for other organisms. When a red fox finishes its meal, it leaves food scraps behind, providing food for scavengers and decomposers. As you can see, the red fox is an integral part of its ecosystem, and they are the ones who can fill that specific role in their particular habitat. We have defined habitat and niche by looking at the specific example of the red fox, but this also applies to other organisms. Let's go back to the polar bear we discussed at the beginning of this lesson. Pause the video and make a list of the polar bear's habitat and niche. You might not know a lot about this animal, and that's okay. Just do your best. Okay, pause the video, and when your list is complete, hit play. You may have listed the Arctic region as part of the habitat for the polar bear. But did you know they live on the sea ice in the Arctic? That is a part of their habitat as well. They also consider a large region of the Arctic home, so they have a wide habitat. This floating sea ice is also their shelter, where they dig dens in the deeper ice. What about the polar bear's niche? This is a little more difficult if you aren't very familiar with the animal. The polar bear is the top of the food chain with no predators. They eat by hunting seals. This very specific diet has an important job in the polar bear's ecosystem. It keeps the balance of the rest of the food web in check, preventing an abundance of seals that would eat too many small fish and crustaceans, which would throw off the balance of the marine biome. This role of the polar bear is referred to as the keystone species, or the species in an ecosystem that keeps the rest of the populations in balance. As we went through the lesson today, we discussed the difference between an organism's habitat and its niche. We specifically did this by studying the red fox and the polar bear. In our next lesson, we will move from the individual to the community as we discuss the relationships that exist between organisms in an ecosystem. Until next time, remember, you're a force of nature, so keep sparking the changes that you want to see. I'll see you next time.